One.
Hi Al, thank you for joining us today. We're going to talk about our T-Disc marketing plan for Tim Hortons. Just getting right into it here, our agenda. We're going to talk about the relevant background, our SWOT analysis, the target market that we're going to be focusing on for this plan, our competitive analysis for the Canadian market. I'm going to overview our marketing plan with the financials, followed by the conclusion. Starting off with the background here of the industry and coffee in Canada, recent drought in Brazil has really hindered the coffee production, so the prices have actually risen the highest they've been since 2012, on average 20%. And when looking at the industry, you can see over here the red line representing the coffee pods and the black line representing the standard fresh ground coffee. You can see that the pods are outperforming the standard coffee, so it's something that we feel like we should focus on for sure. And the single serve background here, it reached $10.8 billion in sales globally as of 2013, and Canada accounted for 45% of those sales. 8 out of 10 cups of coffee in Canada are drank at home, and 38% of Canadians own a single serve brewing station. So these are some pretty solid numbers that we feel like are opportunities to capitalize on. And
So just looking at our SWOT analysis, Tim Hortons itself is very transparent when it comes to the sustainability of their products. And we have a very high recall from our coffee consumers. We are one of the top known brands in Canada. And we do have T-Disc pods that provide a cheaper alternative for the consumer. Just some of the weaknesses is the fact that Tassimo does only offer the 3 flavors of Tim Hortons coffee for the consumers, and we aren't the top of mind T-Disc pods when it comes to consumer purchases. And then just another weakness is due to Tim Hortons only being sold in Canada, all international purchases will have to be done online. And then just the opportunities is Nespresso did try and attempt to come into the North American market. They only maintained a 4% market share. So due to this, they decided to drop out of the market, which allowed us to be able to take over this 4%. There is a growing trend towards sustainable and organic coffee, so consumers are looking for that sustainable aspect when it comes to purchasing their coffee. And there is also a growing trend in the at-home brewing. And then just the threats are, it is such a saturated market, we do have many competitors in this field. And we have the threat of consumers being so used to in-store convenience, so being able to buy their coffee quick rather than having to wait at home. And then our 2 main competitors do have a very established market share in the single serve coffee. So just looking at our potential target market, we are going to be targeting college students aged 18 to 25. And just looking at the amount of students in Canada, there is close to 2 million students in post-secondary schools, but we will be targeting the close to 800,000 students in Ontario. We will do this by conducting some tests at 4 post-secondary locations.
All right, Al, so just to talk to you a little bit about the target market, both of Tim Hortons and the one that we would like to focus on for our test. So the one for Tim Hortons would be all demographics, psychographics, and those of different lifestyles. For example, the on-the-go young professional may be more into the coffees that they can get and go, you know, the quick double-double. Whereas, you know, the kid headed to soccer might be into Timbits. And the elderly person is more of a sit-in, have the soup and sandwich type of person. But for a test, we found that 18 to 25 years old might be the perfect area for single-serve our target market. And that's because 44% of them are at-home brewers, are millennial. So that's 44% of the at-home brewers are millennial. And 74% of them are of gourmet and specialty coffee is consumed by those who are 18 to 29 years old, which ties back into that number. And so...
So just looking at the consumer consumption behavior, we found that women age 19 to 30 are drinking an average of 470 milliliters of coffee a day. Males in the same age group are drinking close to 580 milliliters a day. And we know that one cup of coffee is 175 milliliters. So therefore, students on an average are drinking 3 cups of coffee a day. So when we do the math, 3 pods a day will be used. So that's 90 pods a month. And by the end of the year, if we hit all our target market in Ontario, it will be close to 860 million potential pods being sold in that year. And just knowing that 76% of the coffee being brewed by millennials is traditional coffee.
All right, Alice, so now for a really brief competition analysis for you. What we found is that Keurig outclasses us in terms of flavors offered as well as machines, and their Tim Horton flavors offered are more. Tassimo has more flavors offered than the Nespresso, even with their Virtuo line, but they hold more machines than us at 7 instead of 6. We have all of the same distribution methods as the competitors, except for the Nespresso boutiques, which is sold to Nespresso. And the market share is 53% for Keurig, 25% for Tassimo, and 4% for Nespresso. And finally, this is a cost breakdown analysis of the machine cost and the pod cost, and we come in at 71 cents per pod as Tim Hortons.
All right, so this is the opportunity I'd like to take to break you down with the executional plan. Now, when we look at the objective here, we really want to increase the share of mind within millennials at post-secondary institutions, because we know those are the millennials that are on the go and are trying to get this single-serve coffee. Our strategy is to capitalize on this growing market trend of home brewing among millennials. And the way that we're going to do that is we have two tactics, is that we actually bring these Tassimo brewers and promotional displays to 4 post-secondary campuses: Ryerson University, Brock University, Algonquin, and Flint. We're going to be introducing these packages for $10, and that includes 14 tea discs. As well, we have the opportunity to sample with a 50-cent donation along with your purchase. While quantities last, maintaining a original blend and small size only. Now we look at the advertising plan. So we are strategically focusing on frequency. Because we have a low awareness with tea discs, because this is our first time mass advertising with tea discs, and we need to be competitive in terms of the aggressive competitive media activity. So our idea is that we'll flight time over 16 weeks, starting in September, moving through to December, and having things ready for the Christmas season. In terms of the executional details, a quick summary of our plan is to target these 4 post-secondary institutions, again, Ryerson, Brock, Algonquin, and Fleming, by bringing them our $10 package for tea discs and offering a sample opportunity with 50-cent donations to our Tim Hortons Foundation.
All right, so just to take a look at the financials of the and market potential. So at Ryerson University, we know that there's 36,000 students. We expect a penetration of 6,000. That's about 16.7%, and that number is duplicated throughout because we know that 38% of Canadians own a single serve brewer, and we know that 44% of millennials are responsible for the drinking of at-home brewed coffee. With that in mind, we can take this number, 38% of them, and then 44% of those give us this. So the market value of Ryerson would be just over $60,000. Of Algonquin College would be $35,000, $26,000 for Fleming College, and $29,000 for Brock University. Going into, however, the cost to test in these different universities, at Ryerson University, the pod sent there, we would need $36,000 so that we can ensure that at least one student gets one pod. The cost of that sample would be $1,200, 30 packs. So the 30 packs sell for $19.99, and that breakdown brings us to $23,988. The same breakdown brings us to $13,000, just close to $14,000. Here brings us to just over $10,000, and there just shy of $12,000. And finally, we have also the cost of the Tassimo machines. At Ryerson, we need 9, bringing us to 810. Brock, we need 3, which which brings us to 270, and then one for both Algonquin and Fleming, which is $90 each. So a quick breakdown of that would look like this. That is your Tassimo machines, your T-discs, which makes a total output of $61,909.66. When we take away the possible profit, we are left with a positive of $90,486.34.
So just to conclude our marketing plan, we are recommending to grow the share of mind in post-secondary educational institutions, primarily because of that massive growing going on right now in at-home brewing. And Tim Hortons really wants to stay competitive and stay on top of it. We really want to be sure to extend the product life cycle and maintain that sustainable Tim Hortons brand image. We hope you enjoyed our presentation today, and we hope that we secured your approval.